And behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bowed together, and could in no wise lift up herself. Luke chapter 13, verse 11. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him, and said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. Luke chapter 13, verse 12. The spirit of a man will sustain his infirmity, but a wounded spirit who can bear? Proverbs chapter 18, verse 14. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Romans chapter 8, verse 26. God will redeem my soul from the power of the grave. Psalm chapter 49, verse 15. If my people, who are called by my name, shall humble themselves, and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and I will heal their land. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. For the scripture saith, Whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. Romans chapter 10, verse 11. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. Romans chapter 10, verse 4. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. James chapter 5, verse 14. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Luke chapter 10, verse 9. We know that whoever is born of God sins not, but he that is begotten of God keeps himself, and that wicked one touches him not. 1 John chapter 5, verse 18. These things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. John chapter 16, verse 33. A merry heart doeth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit drieth the bones. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 22. And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Matthew chapter 10, verse 1. He healeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds. Psalm 147, verse 3. The Lord nurses them when they are sick and restores them to health. Psalm 41, verse 3. The Lord will strengthen him upon the bed of languishing. Thou wilt make all his bed in his sickness. Psalm 41, verse 3. Confess your faults one to another, and pray one for another, that ye may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. James chapter 5, verse 16. Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. 3 John chapter 1, verse 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. Psalm 103, verses 2 through 4. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he hath committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. James chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sins, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. Behold, I will bring it health and cure, and I will cure them, and will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 6. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved. For you are the one I praise. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 14. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Psalm 91. order my steps in thy word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. Psalm chapter 119, verse 133. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. Exodus chapter 23, verse 25. And he said unto her, Daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace, and be whole of thy plague. Mark chapter 5, verse 34. O Lord my God, I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. Psalm chapter 30, verse 2. And heal the sick that are therein, and say unto them, The kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. Luke chapter 10, verse 9. Jesus said unto him, If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Mark chapter 9, verse 23. Now when the sun was setting, all they that had any sick with diverse diseases brought them unto him, and he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. Luke chapter 4, verse 40. And he said unto me, My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. Therefore I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 10. Thank you. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Revelation chapter 3, verse 11. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Luke chapter 12, verse 32. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. And I say also unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. I can do all things through Christ which strengtheneth me. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he hath said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 through 18. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. John chapter 14, verse 27. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee. Isaiah chapter 26, verse 3. For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Psalm chapter 29, verse 11. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Numbers chapter 6, verses 24 through 26. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. John chapter 16, verse 7. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me. John chapter 15, verse 26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. John chapter 14, verse 26. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. John chapter 14, verse 16. I am he that comforteth you. Who art thou, that thou shouldst be afraid of a man that shall die, and of the Son of Man which shall be made as grass? Isaiah chapter 51, verse 12. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Psalm chapter 46, verse 1. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill, Selah. Psalm chapter 3, verse 4. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together, and edify one another, even as also ye do. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 through 5. Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Jeremiah chapter 32, verse 27. The blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 22. Then he said unto them, go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord, neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. Hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask, and ye shall receive, that your joy may be full. John chapter 16, verse 24. Charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourn, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 through 3. Came into her and said, Hail, you that are highly favored, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. Luke chapter 1, verse 28. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day, to observe and to do them. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Herein is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. 1 John chapter 4, verse 10. He that loveth not, knoweth not God, for God is love. 1 John chapter 4, verse 8. And we have known and believed the love that God hath to us. God is love. And he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. 1 John chapter 4, verse 16. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 3. Hatred stirreth up strifes, but love covereth all sins. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 12. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. 1 John chapter 4, verse 7. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. Exodus chapter 33, verse 14. Thus saith the Lord, stand ye in the ways and see, and ask for the old paths, where is the good way, and walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. But they said, we will not walk therein. Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 16. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Psalm 37, verse 7. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Numbers chapter 6, verses 24 through 26. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God, and the Lord hath chosen thee to be a peculiar people unto himself, above all the nations that are upon the earth. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 2. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Saying, touch not mine anointed, and do my prophets no harm. Psalm 105, verse 15. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Isaiah chapter 54, verse 17. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. The wicked are overthrown and are not, but the house of the righteous shall stand. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 7. And when ye stand praying, forgive if ye have aught against any, for your Father also which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. Mark chapter 11, verse 25. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 13. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. 1 John chapter 5, verse 7. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. John chapter 1, verse 17. Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Colossians chapter 1, verses 13 and 14. How how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? Hebrews chapter 9, verse 14. But now in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 13. In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7. Thou art my hiding place. Thou shalt preserve me from trouble. Thou shalt compass me about with songs of deliverance. Psalm 32, verse 7. Great deliverance giveth he to his king, and showeth mercy to his anointed, to David, and to his seed forevermore. Psalm chapter 18, verse 50. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. 1 John chapter 1, verse 7. If they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. Job chapter 36, verse 11. But if any provide not for his own, and especially for those of his own house, he hath denied the faith, and is worse than an infidel. 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 8. Recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceable with all men. Romans chapter 12, verses 17 and 18. There hath no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. It shall be health to thy navel, and marrow to thy bones. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 8. He turneth the wilderness into a standing water, and dry ground into water springs. Psalm chapter 107, verse 35. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Oh, Heavenly Father, please forgive me for my sins, and please open up your ear and hear this prayer petition on behalf of your servants, on behalf of those for whom we pray for often, on behalf of those who have been experiencing seizures, on behalf of those who are experiencing sickness, infirmity, or fear of any kind. Body, soul, or mind, Lord, we just ask that you would loose and then bind this prayer to all who would touch and agree. In Jesus' name. Lord, we ask in the authority of the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in the power of his name, that you would please loose and then bind to us the joy of the Lord, which is our strength and restoration now and always. And the oil of joy and gladness to wipe away all sadness and madness. And please keep our lamps filled with the oil of joy and gladness and lit with Holy Spirit fire. Please loosen and bind to us the garment of praise to lift off the spirits of heaviness for all of our nights and our days, and a merry, merry heart to do our entire bodies good like medicine. And Lord, please let that garment of praise never be torn or worn or tattered or battered. And please bind all of these things to us, Lord, in billionfold portions every millisecond, continuously and continually, in Jesus' name. And we also ask that you please loose and then bind to us 2 Timothy 1 and 7, power, love, and a sound mind to us. Oneness with the mind of Christ. Your perfect peace that surpasses all understanding. Your perfect love that casts out all fear. Philippians 4 and 8, positive thoughts. And the perfect peace of one whose mind is stayed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Please also loose and then bind to your servants, Lord, that we would be washed with the blood of Jesus. Let it wash us white as snow and wash away from us anything that needs to go. And please loose and then bind to us the comfort of the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit. Let us be comforted, mind, body, and soul, night and day, in each and every way. Lord, please bind the comfort of the Comforter to our very atmosphere. Wrap us up in its warmth, night and day. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, we also ask that you loosen and bind to us John 14:26, and let all things that Jesus Christ has said be brought back to our remembrance. Loose us, Heavenly Father, Lord, from lust of the flesh, lust of the eye, pride of life, respect of persons, and idolatry, and any infirmity. Lord, I also ask in the authority of the name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord of Lords and King of Kings, that you would bind the precious balm in Gilead to all who would touch and agree. In Jesus' name. And bind that precious balm, Lord, to any part of us, any place, Lord, where there's anything missing or lacking or broken or bruised or battered or fragmented or fractured or split or splintered. Anything that needs to be repaired, restored, refreshed, fixed, healed, or renewed. Please repair, restore, refresh, fix, heal, and renew us like the eagle's wings concerning all needful things in Jesus' name. And Lord, we also ask that you would please, Lord, bind to us, Lord, your supernatural, miraculous, and instantaneous healing like you gave to the man who was born blind in John chapter 9. You are no respecter of persons, Lord. The same supernatural and miraculous and instantaneous healing that you gave to him, you will give to us, and that much more, in Jesus' name. And Lord, please loose your servants, all who would touch and agree, from defiance, denial, rebellion, witchcraft, sorcery, ancestral, generational, familial or familiar, curses, hexes, spirits or spells, going all the way back to the beginning of our generations. Loose us from any agreements made knowingly or unknowingly or on our behalf with the gods of pagans. Loose us from frustration, impatience, agitation, aggravation, and irritation. Loose us from anything coming over our mind, any haze, daze, illusion, confusion, or hallucination, any shifting of the room, any spiritual veil or blinders placed over our eyes or mind, any spirits assigned to make us spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally, or otherwise blind, any seizing spirits or any other types of spirits, Lord God, that would cause convulsions or blackouts, in the name of Jesus, loose us from these. So Lord, bind to us that supernatural healing, Lord, like you gave to the man who was born blind in John chapter 9. And bind to us that supernatural, miraculous, and instantaneous deliverance like you gave to the man of the tombs and the Gadarenes in Luke chapter 8, verse 33. Open up the prison to them that are bound and set the captives free. Loose us from any and all forms of bondage, imprisonment, and captivity, spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally, psychologically, and otherwise, in Jesus' name. And loose us from every ungodly soul tie, all ungodly soul ties, fetters, shackles, tethers, ungodly cords, and chains, and remove every stumbling block from out of our way, in Jesus' name. And loose us, Heavenly Father, Lord, from any spirits that may have us bound in any way like the man was bound in Luke 8 and 33. Loose your servants, Lord, from any mental torment or anguish in Jesus' name, from trauma in Jesus' name, and from deep hurt in Jesus' name, from heaviness and depression, from death, hell, and the grave, resignation from life and suicide, and from inviting death and wanting death. And loose your servants, Heavenly Father, Lord, from anything, Lord, that would cause for them to be bound and cause for them to be free and free indeed. Loosed from loneliness, isolation, seclusion, desolation, desperation, despondency, defeatism, dejection, rejection, resentment, bitterness, bitter root, judgment, abandonment, betrayal, disloyalty, disappointment, rage, anger, hard-heartedness, heart of stone, retaliation, revenge, avengement, vengeance, and grudge, and every unloved spirit and spirits that try to make us feel unloved, and any other spirit that would apply, that keeps us from being free and free indeed. Loose us from these, bind them up, cast them out, and cast them down to wherever Lord Jesus Christ says they belong, and don't let them rise back up and come back around, in Jesus' name. Keep them bound in everlasting unbreakable chains. And Lord, cause for us to be as that man was from Luke 8 and 33 after Jesus Christ delivered him, seated at the feet of Jesus, fully clothed and in our right minds, continuously and continually, perpetually and permanently, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we also ask that you would please loose and then bind to us, Lord, Psalm 23, Psalm 91 and Ephesians 6 and all the promises and protections therein, please lead us beside the still waters. Maketh us to lie down in green pastures. Restore our souls. Let us know that you are indeed our shepherd, and we shall not want for anything. And Lord, please loose and then bind to us, Lord, the angels that you have assigned to us, Lord. And let no plague come near our dwelling, in Jesus' name. And Lord, please loosen and bind to us the whole full armor of God from Ephesians 6, and bind to that whole full armor impenetrability, and let it never deplete. And please bind the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ to us from the crown of our heads all the way down to the soles of our precious and beautiful feet, for beautiful are the feet that carry the gospel. And Lord, we also ask in the name of Jesus and the power of his name that you would bind this same type of whole full armor to those angels that you have assigned to watch over us. Loose those angels right now, Lord, to go to us and to surround us and link arms around us like bodyguards. And we plead the blood of Jesus over them and their armor too. And let them protect us, Lord, in our dwellings made of flesh and bone, as well as our dwellings made of brick and stone, our mind, body, and soul, spirit, man, and everything that you've made us a steward over and or allowed for us to own, especially any pets or our home or vehicle. And let those angels be with us everywhere we roam, inside or outside the home, to protect us from things seen and unseen and all things unclean, known and unknown. And please loosen and bind to your servants, Lord, 1 Corinthians 13, love, and the seven spirits of the Lord from Isaiah 11 and 2. Let us first and foremost always feel that love flowing and emanating from you, but let us always be vessels that love can flow freely through in those seven spirits too. And let us be able to recognize and realize when you send that love through others to be a blessing for us too. And Lord, let those who are lovers in this world, Lord, those who are truly full of your love, in Jesus' name, those who sow seeds of true godly love, Lord, let them receive a bountiful harvest of good fruit of that same unconditional godly agape love, in Jesus' name. For the love of many has waxed cold, and some who are lovable find it hard to be loved, according to 1 Corinthians 13's definition. Lord, we also ask in the name of Jesus and the power of his name that you would please loose and then bind to us, over us, under us, around us, and surround us with a greater hedge of protection than you gave to your servant Job in Job chapter 1, verse 10, because we ask that you won't let anything that would harm us or come against us be able to penetrate through that hedge and get in. And anything that's in there with us now that should not be, we ask that you would loose us from it, Lord. Cause for us to be made free. Loose that thing to wherever it needs to be. Bind to that protective hedge, a protective ceiling, foundation, floors, walls, and roof. And with the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, seal it and make it airtight. And we ask that you would do all of these things according to your will for our life, which is that we live and not die, that we prosper and be in good health, even that our souls may prosper, and that you give us that hope and that future and that good expected end, according to the plans that you have for us in your perfect will. And Lord, we also ask that you loose a Holy Spirit firewall of protection as high, far, and wide as the eye can see, to cover and protect us from every direction, and seal it with a protective ceiling, foundation, floors, walls, and roof, and with the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, seal it and make it airtight. And let nothing be able to come through there, Lord, that would come against our life. And Lord, we ask these things according to your word in Matthew 7 and 7, Matthew 18 and 18 through 18 and 20, Matthew 21 and 22, Isaiah 55 and 11, Numbers 23 and 19, Luke chapter 8, verse 33, and John chapter 9, just to name a few. We ask that you would bind these scriptures and these prayers and all of the promises and protections within it. But most importantly, Lord, bind your word and your promises in your word to provide for us, to protect us, to heal us, and to deliver us. And bind all of these things, Lord, as the proof that your promises toward us have been kept. Bind all of these things, Lord, to your servants in Jesus' name. All who are listening, touching and agreeing in the name of Jesus. And Lord, to their medications or their vaccinations or their flu shots or their food or their drink, their supplements, anything that they take into their gates and anything that they come out of their gates to, Lord, we ask in Jesus' name, Lord, that it would all be purified by you in Jesus' name. and that you would bind these prayers to those things too in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we ask you to bind these things, Lord, also to our mind, will, emotions, imagination, intellect, to our subconscious and conscious thoughts, and to our memory. And please cause for us to be healed and made whole instantly, and let us remain healed and whole continuously and continually, perpetually and permanently in the name of Jesus. For you are a great physician, greater than a great pharmacist, psychologist, psychiatrist, or therapist. So please, we make any medications or vaccinations or flu shots or food or drink or supplements that your children have taken according to your specifications in Jesus' name. And please, Lord, we ask that you would loose those things, Lord, from having any negative effects, special effects, side effects, hexes, spirits, spells, chemicals, curses, or ingredients that you, the great physician, would not use, prescribe, or agree with. Loose those things and loose us from any of those things aforementioned. And Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus that you would bind to anything that your servants have taken in an attempt to try to be well. Lord, I ask in Jesus' name, Lord, because they trusted their doctors or they trusted their therapists or their psychiatrists or whomever was qualified to give them something for healing. We know that you are the only healer. So we ask, Lord, that you would bind to those things, that they'll only bless and add no sorrow with them, and that they'll only be vessels through which rest, restoration, peace of mind, healing, wellness, wholeness, and good health can flow. For as you alone are the great physician, you also know the importance of rest to our healing. So please loosen and bind to us every time that it's time to rest or we need to rest. Psalm 4 and 8 and Proverbs 3 and 24, sweet sleep. And bind to us, Lord, the knowledge that you maketh us to dwell in safety only. And cast down imaginations and bring thoughts into captivity and submission to the will of Christ and every spirit associated with them. In Jesus' name. And loose us from sleeplessness, restlessness, insomnia, amnesia, nightmare, mare, or anything, Heavenly Father, that would interfere with our sweet sleep. And our ability to remember that you maketh us to dwell in safety only. Let us remember that whether we're asleep or we're awake, let us know that you'll make us only safe. And Lord, I also ask in the name of Jesus and the power of his name, that you would please, out of your grace and out of your mercy and out of your love for your servants, bind to them that they will have only sweet dreams, and that it will always culminate into them having a blessed rest. And let them wake up at your appointed time, rejuvenated and refreshed, filled with your zeal and your zest, feeling their very best, knowing that they're highly favored and blessed, ready to receive love, joy, peace, hope, healing, and happiness, because they're fearfully and wonderfully made. And to claim victory in the authority of the name of the Lord and Savior, King Jesus. So we touch and agree in the name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Son, as we seal this prayer with Isaiah 55 and 11. And we ask that these prayers will reach your ears like a Holy Ghost pillar of fire and flame, unhindered, and that these prayers would be answered, returned unto us as answered in the same manner, unhindered, in the power and authority of the name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, but answered as proof that your promises toward us have been kept. In Jesus' mighty, matchless, holy name, we touch and agree, and we call it done. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Savior and Son. Amen and amen.